Hi everyone, and welcome to the latest video from St. John's Church in Weymouth. You join me on a very, very sunny day here in Weymouth. The sun is shining, it's a beautiful day. I hope you're enjoying the summer wherever you are as well. This little video is an update on the Renewal Project. The Renewal Project is the project that we are working on with this magnificent building behind me. St. John's Church is in a busy, prominent part of Weymouth. We're situated just on the seafront, and as you can probably hear from the traffic around me, we see a lot of passers-by both on foot and by vehicle throughout the day. And we just know that we have this incredible, historic, large, beautiful, prominent building which God has given us. And the Renewal Project is all about us trying to make the very best of it for the things that we believe that God is calling us to. And so this is a little update. Quite a few things have happened in recent months towards the Renewal Project. So here's a little update on all the things that we have going on. There are two questions at the heart of the Renewal Project. How can we use this amazing building to glorify God? And how can we use it to bless the community? That's what all this is about. We want to point people to Jesus, and we want to serve and bless this incredible community that we live in. Well, we're inside the church now, away from the noise of the traffic. And it's inside the church that really the most significant changes are going to take place as part of the Renewal Project, which I'm going to just quickly talk you through now. You know, it's around 35 years since the last major reordering project was undertaken here at St. John's. And I know that many of you who are watching this video were part of the church back then, and you gave generously and you prayed generously for that project. And what that project did was that it enabled a new season, a new chapter for the life of the church, a new set of opportunities for mission and ministry, new opportunities to reach new people. So thank you to those of you who gave in so many ways all of those years ago to enable future generations to enjoy this place and to meet Jesus here and to worship God here and to find friendship and build relationships here. It was an amazing thing that you did. But now all of those years on, we go again, and it's time again to invest, and it's our turn. It's the turn of those who are newer to the church to invest with your time and your prayers and your work and your money if you're able to, so that we can do what those people did all those years ago. We can enable a new chapter in the life of the church. We can do things which will reach new people. And so here are some of the things that we're going to be doing. We're going to be replacing these chairs. 35 years ago, the big decision was taken to remove the pews, which of course have a beauty and a history of their own. But they went many years ago, replaced with these chairs, which have served us well. But their time is now up. They're really, really heavy to move around, as many of you know. You will testify to that. And increasingly uncomfortable. They're looking tired. They're looking worn. And part of creating this welcoming, comfortable, hospitable place will be to replace the chairs. So we're looking at getting lightweight chairs, which are easier to move around, easier to kind of rearrange the church in different ways, depending on the services that we're having, but still just as comfortable as the ones that we've got. So part of what we're applying for permission for is to replace the chairs. You could pray, actually, that we're given permission to use the chairs that the congregation have voted for. So church will be a place where people can come in, they'll look great, and people will be comfortable as well. While we're talking about furniture, we're also going to be investing in a little bit of furniture which will go at this end of the church. I'm now at the rear of the church. This is where we kind of do our mingling and drink coffee after services. We'd love here to create really, we'll just get into the light, a community cafe type space, a space with tables and chairs and nice places where tea, coffee and cake are served from, where people can come in. Maybe it's going to be for coffee mornings during the week, for light lunches, for things in the evening, maybe for young people to come along to, for young adults to come along to, a place just to come and spend time with each other, to build community, to build friendship and be served, and for us to be hospitable along the way. So there'll be some new furniture which is placed at the back of the church here as that sort of place of hustle and bustle and relationship building and drinking coffee and having cake and all of those kind of things. Really important part of that project is that we don't want the font, which is such an important part of the church, such an important part of our history and our heritage, we don't want the font to be lost in that kind of hustle and bustle. And so the font's going to be relocated over to beneath the stained glass window on the middle of the north wall. That will enable it to be a prayer station, a place where we can go and sit around it and to pray. The font marks for many people the beginning of their journey of faith, and so it will be a great place to go and pray around it, to reflect on your own journey of faith. And really, we want to make this a real feature of the church rather than it just kind of be a little bit lost in the cafe area. So the font will move as well. The walls are all going to be repainted. You can see behind me that we're already in preparation for that happening. And so on the 24th of August, the scaffolders come in, and all of the white walls are going to be repainted white, and the damaged areas are going to be made good. And you can see, particularly on the west wall behind me, that there's a real need for that to take place. And so by the time you're next in church, the chances are it's going to look a whole lot fresher and brighter and cleaner. And the cobwebs are going to come down as well, which I think have been up there for many years too. In due course as well, we're going to replace the carpet. Again, like the chairs, it's been here for 35 years. Served us really, really well, but you wouldn't have to look too closely to realise that it's in need of replacement. And so that's something we're going to be looking to do as well. I want to walk you over to perhaps the area of the church which we're most excited about seeing significant changes in. And it all relates to what is behind this wall behind me here. At the moment, you can just see a plain wall. Behind it is a room which has been used for many years for children's work, for youth work, and again, incredible legacy of the work that was taking place, that took place 35 years ago. Now with other rooms available and Hope House just across the way, there's other places for us to do really good children's and youth work. And so what's going to happen in this room here is the installation of a kitchen. We don't have a kitchen at St. John's. We have a sink and a kettle and a few drawers. But what we would love, and I know many of you are longing for this, is to be able to properly serve the community with food and with meals. And so we're going to have a really good quality kitchen put in the room just behind me here with a serving hatch here in this wall, which then food will be taken down to the cafe area that we've just talked about. We're going to have a really good dishwasher. So all of those years of washing up manually, hopefully are over. Really good ovens, a place where we can really bless the community with food. Jesus understood that food was integral to blessing people and to mission and ministry. And it's going to be so important as we look to the future as well. So excited to see a really good kitchen put in that room just behind us there. Fantastic thing to look forward to. As you saw from when I was outside, it's a very sunny day today. But even on this sunny day, to do this video, I've had to turn on all the lights in the church. It's not naturally an overly light space, but that's partly to do with the quality of the lights that we have. We would love, A, for the church to feel lighter and brighter, but also for us to have more options in terms of atmospheric lighting. And so part of the project is that we're going to be not so much adding loads of new lighting in, but just improving the lights that we've got, improving the way in which they're controlled, so that we can accentuate the historical architectural features of the church, but also that we can just have a better lit space for people to come and enjoy being in. One of those beautiful parts of the church is, of course, the chancel. And I'm going to take you up to the chancel now. The chancel is one of the most beautiful parts of the church, steeped in history, full of interesting wood features, stone features, architectural features. There's the stained glass window with the ascended Christ depicted. This is an incredible place to pray. It's an incredible place to be in God's presence, to worship. We know God's everywhere, but there's something so special about being in this part of the church. But at the moment, it's really inaccessible. It's very hard to get to if you have trouble with mobility and if you're using a wheelchair, or even if you wanted to bring a pram or a buggy up here. And so we want to make the chancel as accessible as we possibly can. And so the plan is to bring the communion rails down a step, eliminating one of the steps that people currently have to get up to take communion up here. And what we're going to do at this end of the chancel, the green surface below me, it's not a miniature golf course, it's actually the stage, or the dais, to give it its proper name. We're going to raise the stage to be the same height as this step here. So once you're on the dais, you don't need to go up any more steps to be fully in the chancel. But we're going to raise the stage. So how do you get onto the stage in the first place if it's going to be even higher? Well, we're going to have a ramp, and the ramp is going to be situated just about where I'm standing now. And so a ramp will begin around here and go up onto the dais. And for those who don't need a ramp but do just need a little bit of help getting up the steps, there's going to be some handrails positioned centrally on the stepped access up to the new dais. And what it means is that any service in the chancel is fully accessible, and anyone can go there to pray if they're just visiting the church and wanting a quiet space to be. There's no barrier to anyone getting up to that part of the church. I'm so excited about all of these things, and it's great to start to see these things happening. And please do pray for all of these changes as well. And so what we're going to do now, we're going to pop back outside to hear about another couple of things that are going to be taking place. If you've been to St. John's Church at any point in the last few winters, you'll know that we've had all kinds of trouble with our heating system. And for sometimes months on end, you've been coming to church with extra layers on and blankets over your knees. And we've been filling the place with as many fan heaters as we possibly can. I'm delighted to say that the first part of the renewal project has in fact happened, thanks to your generosity, and we now have a new heating unit in place. This one works a treat, and so when the church is up and running again, we look forward to sitting there in warmth and comfort as we worship God together. And so it's great to see that the new heating unit is in place. When this church was originally built in 1854, the stepped entrance behind me was the main entrance. You can see it's the bottom of the tower, and we've been using a different entrance for quite a few years, and that's a great entrance that we normally use. It's level access, so it's great for wheelchairs and prams. We'll continue to use that entrance, but part of the project is we want to restore this as one of the ways in which people can get into the church. At the moment, you can just see it's gated off. There's a big porch behind it, and behind that porch is our current kitchenette, which, as I've already explained, we won't be needing anymore. So part of the project is that this magnificent west-facing entrance to the church can be restored as a way in which people can A, from the road, see that the church is open, alive, well and active, and B, have that impressive entrance to the church too. So that's part of the project that we're also looking forward to. Another really important part of the plan is to increase the capacity of the car parks. We've got a car park here that you can see behind me, and also one just down at the other end of the church as well. Praise God that our church is growing. But what that means is that the car park is absolutely crazy on a Sunday morning. And what we want to do is just alleviate some of the pressure on the car park just by expanding it a little bit and putting a better quality of surface down as well. So that will be a huge part of the church being accessible and welcoming, that when people turn up here to worship, they're able to park without a problem. So there we go. That's your update on the renewal project. So much going on, so much that we'd love you to pray for, and so much to be excited about as well. We're certainly just imagining and dreaming of all of the opportunities that the changes to the building will allow for, and we hope that you're excited about this project as well. A massive thank you to those of you who have given to the project. We were blown away by the initial response of the church investing really generously, sacrificially into this project. But it will probably not surprise you to know that we still need some more. And we are absolutely committed to stewarding the money well, to not being frivolous, to not being wasteful. There's a whole team of people working really hard on making sure that the money is spent really, really wisely. But at the same time, we don't want to compromise on quality of things. We want this to be a long-lasting project which makes a difference to future generations. So if you've already given, thank you. I'm not asking you to give again. If you haven't given, but would like to, any amount, you're really, really welcome to do so. And if you're part of the church, you've probably received an email to go with this message with the information about how to give. You might not be part of the church, or you might not have that information, and you might want to give. We are not going to stand in your way. Contact me through the church Facebook page or the church website, and we can talk about how you could give to the project as well. And so we're so grateful. We've had so much support for this project, but it's a big project, it's a big building. There's a lot we want to see change, and a lot we want to achieve, a big difference really that we want to make in this community as we go about those two driving purposes. We want to glorify God, and we want to bless the community. We believe this space can enable us to do both with these changes.
So thank you for your time. Thanks for sticking with this video. I hope it's been a useful update for you. I hope it will help you to pray. Pray now for the next part of the process. We've applied for lots of permission from the diocese to do all of these things, and they look at it in great detail, and we hope early in the autumn we'll get the green light to get on with a lot of these things, which we'll then do in the autumn term. So prayers for a smooth process, and that we would be enabled to do all that we believe God is calling us to do. So thanks for your help, thanks for your prayers, thanks for your support, and we look forward to the next opportunity we have to update you on the Renewal Project. I'm off back out to the sunshine to enjoy. You should do the same. God bless, and we'll see you very soon.